Hey, hello, nice to meet you. In this episode, we're not gonna make an RC airplane, but it is still in development and it's not finished yet. I'm planning to make this RC airplane affordable as possible, and I'm just focusing on 100% DIY building, including the transmitter and receiver, and which is also in development. When I finish that, I will drop the video. I know flying an RC airplane is a dream of everyone, including me. So one of the most important things to be considered to make an RC airplane is the weight of the aircraft. We have to know and estimate the weight of every component that we're going to put on it. So, we need a weight measuring device, a weight scale. I already have one. It will measure my body weight precisely. But the problem here though, it will not going to do a little tiny weight like this. See? So the kitchen weight scales are better for this kind of application. Unfortunately, I didn't have that one. What are we going to do? Buy one from the online or the nearest retailer? I'm not gonna do that. The point is, I made a weight scale with some scraps around me, and here it is. It will do weight in ounces, grams, pounds as well. Most of the time, every airplane's calculations are done by weight in ounces. So in my point of view, it would be the best DIY version of the weight scale, and especially helpful for lightweight RC airplane builders and for the kitchen too. This video has 3 chapters, working and assembly, calibration, firmware flashing, everything is important. At the end of this video, I will give you this as a gift. Let's dive in. Let's start with the components required: a piece of plywood and a weight scale motherboard. We can talk about the circuit diagram in a moment. Some nuts and bolts and fiberglass faces. We're gonna use a square piece of fiberglass for the wing platform. I just drilled 2 holes on it for the screw mount, and this is the main guy. It's one of the main parts of our machine. It's a weight sensor. We're gonna call it load cell, having a capacity of 1 kg. These kinds of load cells are made up of something called a strain gauge, which may look like this. It's a kind of resistor but has a bit of an elastic type of property, so we can stretch and compress the material. If you stretch the material, it will increase the resistance, and the compression will decrease the resistance. If you do nothing, then it will back to its original resistance. On a load cell, the strain gauges are arranged like this and wired like a vision bridge. Ideally, the 4 strain gauge resistance are equal, so the bridge is in balance. As a result, the output voltage is 0. But when we apply a load on it, the strain gauge R1, R3 go under tension, R4, R2 go under compression, which will make the bridge out of balance. That will make a voltage deflection at the output. And this output voltage is directly proportional to the load that we apply to it. You know, the voltage is too small, within the range of milli or microvolts, so it is impossible to detect with an onboard 10-bit ADC of a microcontroller. But with the help of a 24-bit ADC and a decent MCU, we can read the voltage and convert that back to the applied load. I mean, weight. That's what exactly we're gonna do today, and that's how the weighing machine works. Okay, let's go back to the build. However, I got this fiberglass piece from an LCD panel of an old broken LCD monitor, and it's a kind of a strong material according to the purpose that we are going through. That's why I use this for weighing platform and the spaces too. Okay guys, let's enjoy the build. Guys, this is important. This arrow is showing the direction for applying the force, so we have to mount this load cell like the arrow pointing downwards. Okay? Guys, tighten the bolts as best as you can, but don't try to break them. Guys, another important thing for mounting the beam platform to the load cell, that is, before we're gonna tie the screws, just give some support under the load cell like this. Otherwise, there's a 99.9% chance you may break the load cell. So just be careful about that, okay? Now we can remove the support, it's perfect, you know. Now we're gonna solder the wires of the load cell to the motherboard. Only 4 wires, easy connection. Listen, the red one goes to E positive, black one goes to E negative, and the white one goes to A negative. Finally, the green one goes to A positive. You may reverse the green and white wires, it's not a kind of a problem, but it will reverse the reading. If you are curious, just experiment with yourself, okay? For powering the weight scale, we're gonna use a USB cable. The black wire goes to the ground rail of the circuit and the red one goes to the positive power rail. We don't need this green and white wires, it's just a dotted line of the USB, so just leave it, okay? Hell yeah! Now you successfully assembled the machine. In the next step, that's chapter 2, we have to calibrate the machine. If you listen carefully, it's really simple. Let's dive in. For powering the machine, we can use a cell phone charger or batteries between 4 to 5 volts. I'm gonna use a Samsung 5V 1-amp charger, so just plug the USB cable and fire it up. In the booting time, it will automatically charge the weight to make everything zero. Now I'm gonna go to put a 50 gram weight on it. Let's see what's gonna happen. See, even though we put a 50 gram weight, the reading is still zero. Why is that? Because we didn't calibrate the weight scale yet. For the calibration, we can use these four buttons. This is the calibration constant up button and calibration constant down button. This is enter or save, and this is the exit button. And finally, this is the clear or tear button. You don't want to worry about the button names because I mentioned everything as well as in the circuit diagram. So let's calibrate the weight scale. Try to increment the calibration constant by this calibration constant up button. See, I know when they pop up, but it's not incrementing the calibration constant. And which shows like the weight is 9 grams and calibration constant K is also none. Let's try to decrement the value. Again, it's not possible. Because the value is none means not a number. To change that, for the first time, we have to set that value to a known number using a CEDAR terminal app with your PC or smartphone. There are many ways to interface the circuit with our PC. One of them is using a USB to TTL module. If you have the module, you could wire it up like this. If you don't have it, then you can remove the chip and use your Arduino as a USB to TTL module like this. Or you can use a Bluetooth module like this and pair it with your smartphone and use the CEDAR Bluetooth terminal app. I'm gonna stick with the second one, remove the chip and wire it up. This time we don't need to power the circuit, so I'm gonna leave the cable because it will get power from the USB to TTL module. In my case, I'm using Arduino as a USB to TTL module, so plug the Arduino into the computer and fire it up. Then press the tire or clear button to make everything zero. The bars on the screen is showing the tiring process. I'm gonna use the Arduino serial monitor as the serial terminal app. So open up the Arduino IDE and select the connected port, which is COM3. Then open the serial monitor. Here we go. Make sure and keep it in the null line ending and 9600 baud rate. Now we can see the output of our weight scale. Here, W stands for weight, which is equal to none grams. None means not a number. Weight in ounces is none, weight in pounds is none, and the calibration constant K is none. For setting the K value, I made a commanding setup in the firmware, and the command is put K. So enter put K, press enter, then the system will get you. See, enter a new value for K to continue, tap exit button 2 times to exit. So we don't want to exit, we want to set the K value. So enter the K value, I'm gonna go with 1000 and press enter. For saving the enter value, do what the machine would say. Enter OK to save or I need to exit, tap enter button to save, exit button to exit. We have to save the value, so enter OK and press enter. See, it saved the value. Now all nuns change to 0.00 and now the K value is 1000. Now let's place a known weight. I'm gonna place a 50 gram weight, but the machine reads 57.6 grams. We know it's not accurate and we are in the middle of the calibration process. So play with the calibration constant and adjust the K value to get the known weight accurately. You can always set float numbers for better precision like this. And the steps are the same. Okay, to save, I'm gonna reboot the machine. In the booting time, it's automatically tired the weight, so just remove the weight. place the weight again. See, for the gap value 1155.50 gives me almost 50 grams, but it's a little bit off. We can fix that. Now the buttons are accessible because we changed the non-care value to no number, so we can use the buttons for further adjustments. We can increase the care value or decrease the care value. I'm gonna decrease the care value. Adjust the value for the accurate non-weight. So the value 1153.50 gives me the accurate non-weight reading, and these little fluctuations are negligible because it's less than 0.1 grams. To save the value, just press the enter or save button of the machine. That's all about the calibration. Hell yeah, precise 50 grams. Let's talk about how to flash the firmware. To flash the firmware, we need a programmer, but I don't have that one. Not a big deal, we can make one with the Arduino. So, open up the Arduino IDE, go to Files, Examples, browse the Arduino as ISP sketch, open it up, just upload it. Now this Arduino is an ISP programmer, and now we have to wire this programmer to the target chip on the breadboard. So if you are using a brand new chip, then you have to follow this diagram, or if you are on a program and already used chip, then you have to follow this diagram. The value of the crystal and the capacitor C1, C2 are the same as that you previously used with that chip because it's need the same oscillator setup. I'm gonna flash this to a brand new chip, so I'm gonna follow the first diagram. That's why you couldn't see that crystal on the breadboard, okay? Open AVR Dudes, it's a flash tool for AVR chips. Then select the programmer as Arduino. Set the preset to Arduino as ASP. Select the programmer connected port. Then tap the detect button. If you did everything on the right track, then you can see the chip detected dialog on the black window. It successfully detected my chip. I'm using an Atmega 328, not 328P, but this firmware will work fine on both variants. Now we have to browse the firmware, which is on my desktop in this folder. So click on the browse tab, browse the firmware hex file, open it. Check the erase flash and EEPROM checkbox. It's not necessary, but it's a good practice. Now we have to set the fuse bit configuration. So clear all the text boxes right here and open the folder where you have the fuse config text file. Open it and copy all the values to the same text boxes. So copy the low fuse value to low fuse text box, high fuse value to high fuse text box, like that. Then check the set fuse, set lock checkboxes, and double check everything. Then hit the program button. You can see all the programming clauses on the bottom black window. If your programming is successful, then you will get a verified message under each reading process. So we got the verified message. We successfully programmed our chip. That's all about how to flash the firmware, guys. Now the chip is programmed. Now we can insert the chip to the motherboard. Holy moly.
Searching for greatness in a sea of the dying and shameless, a sea of the aimless. I don't wanna be one of the nameless. I'ma wake up with the mindset that one day I'm gonna make it, and I don't think I'll be fine if I don't break my limitations. Don't try to stop me, I exist to write my own story. I'll make a decision if I want some peace or if I want the glory. Yeah, don't want a life that is complacent or possibly boring. I just want a life that is worth every day exploring. My whole life I just wanted someone who would notice me. My whole life I just wanted to be somebody to be.
Well. 50 grams of total thrust, 120 grams of weight. As per what we got, it's not gonna fly. But we can fix that.